Terminators, unmanned vehicles, synthetic organisms. Is the military merging human DNA and artificial intelligence to create killing machines that will one day rule the world?
Whatever ability or function that the human body has, there is a scientist somewhere trying to make a robot do the exact same thing.
Does the government already have a real-life Skynet that is capable of running a war with no human intervention?
Right now we're facing a free-for-all. There are military contractors, mad scientists, scientists driven to make money, and they're all trying to create the most efficient machines that will make human beings completely expendable.
Tonight, science fiction becomes science fact as the fast-approaching rise of the machines is unsealed. What if the history you were taught in school was all a lie? Is our government controlled by a secret society? Welcome to the world of conspiracy, where cover-ups, secrets, and hidden agendas all trace back to a single source. We're about to unseal the secret files the government doesn't want you to know about. This is Unsealed, Conspiracy Files. 1917, World War I. Trenches scar the face of Europe as Allied and enemy forces dig into the ground. In an attempt to gain the upper hand, the United States Army secretly rushes to manufacture an unpiloted airplane known as the Kettering Bug. It is the first military drone to ever hit the skies, carrying 180 pounds of explosives with a target range of 75 miles.
Aviation was in its infancy, yet we're already trying to figure out how to use this technology as a weapon.
In the 1930s, Russia develops the teletank, a mechanized monster with a built-in flamethrower and machine gun. In the 1940s, the Nazis roll out the Goliath tracked mine, a deadly miniature remote-controlled tank. The first baby steps of the rise of the machines. Seventy years later, the U.S. now has the largest and most powerful army of unmanned drones in the world.
Technology has completely changed war as we've fought it for the last couple thousand years. Now we can fight those battles and take another man's life without ever putting ourselves into harm's way.
And much of the technological progress can be linked to one organization, the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency.
DARPA was created in 1958 by President Dwight D. Eisenhower after the launch of Sputnik by the Soviet Union in 1957. Its purpose was simple. It was aimed to research all those highly advanced scientific discoveries and take the next step in regards to technology.
DARPA has been critical in the development of NASA, the Internet, and the stealth bomber. But that's just the tip of the technological iceberg.
DARPA is a very open agency because they do talk a lot about what they are researching, what they're investigating, and some of the scientific advances that they have taken. But if they'll tell us that much, you have to ask yourself, what aren't they telling you?
One product of DARPA research is the Nano Hummingbird. The 1 ounce flyer can move backwards, forwards, and hover in one place. With funding from DARPA, Big Dog was developed to carry heavy loads over rough terrain.
These things are real. They're not fiction. Luckily, these are ours, at least for the time being.
HiBot Snake is an amphibious device that's mobile on solid ground and in the water.
As science makes these advances, they start creating robots that do very small things. One can carry heavy loads, another jumps very high. When you start putting all of that technology together, all of a sudden you have a super soldier, you have an ultimate machine.
And then there are the drones. One in three military aircraft operates without a human pilot. And their numbers increase every day.
In the beginning, there was a man in the middle of Nevada or DC or even just outside the battlefield that was controlling this piece of machinery. But now, as technology advances, these machines can actually fly themselves.
As machines begin to outnumber the human soldier, will the technology we are creating to assist us turn against us?
Right now, the intelligent machines are on our side because they're programmed to be.
If you think the coming robot apocalypse is going to be nation versus nation, think again. Many of the machines most likely to stage an uprising are already in our homes.
It's crazy to think that these devices can't be used against us. And if something can be used against us, they will be used against us.
Unsealed. Conspiracy Files. Welcome back to the world of conspiracy. This is Unsealed. Conspiracy Files. Every year, the machines we make get one step closer to replacing us altogether. But instead of being wary of robots, Americans just embrace them all the more. Unsealed Case File. Smart Toys. 1998, the American International Toy Fair in New York City. A fuzzy, talking figure soon becomes the must-have Christmas gift of the season. The Furby is the first successful attempt to sell a robot to the domestic market. Prices for the electronic toy soon top $100 on the resale market.
Furby would come and it would only know the language Furbish. Kids would teach it how to learn in English, learn words.
The Furby automatically records bits and pieces of its owner's conversations. Consumers are fascinated. The National Security Administration bans the toy from their offices.
Simply by listening to us, it was becoming intelligent. And shouldn't the NSA ban give us a clue about the path we're going down?
1 year later, the Sony robot dog Aibo further solidifies the consumer's love of a robot companion.
There's a huge difference between remote control robots and autonomous robots. Autonomous robots don't need human interaction. They can literally make a decision for itself and be programmed to completely live its robotic life by its own.
With just minor adjustments, these robot dogs can take and send photographs wirelessly. A few more tweaks allow several to work together as a soccer team.
They're learning, they're working together, and they're sending photos of their surroundings to people. How is that not setting off alarm bells?
Just 1 year later, in 2000, Honda introduces the first humanoid robot for home use. They name him Azimo for Advanced Steps in Innovative Mobility. His stated goal? To assist humans with physical limitations.
The idea and the concept was there that one day we would rely on these robots to help us with our everyday tasks.
From welding to vacuuming, from performing delicate surgery, to making noodles. There seems to be no limit to what a robot can learn to do. And they're talking to each other.
My Roomba has a USB port and a Bluetooth. Who does it need to communicate with?
We openly share our personal info via social networks. We willingly allow our every move to be tracked by GPS.
Imagine an artificial intelligence software utilizing all that data. It can literally map your entire life.
1 billion Facebook users on 1 billion smartphones. Each cell phone and profile containing hundreds of bits of information about you and all your contacts.
If you look at our technological infrastructure, our banking information, our power grids, our telephones, they're all connected in some way. That's a digital Armageddon waiting to happen.
Intelligent robots and computers have been gathering data on mankind for years. Now we're serving it up to them on a silver platter.
First, we like the interconnectedness. We think it's great. But pretty soon, we become dependent on these devices. Pretty soon, we can't live without these devices. And that's the whole point.
Scientists program the most dangerous robots not to harm their creators. But computers, just like the people they may someday replace, are subject to illness.
The common cold has mutated itself over the years to make sure that not every pill or antibiotic that we're given will combat it. Well, same is true in the digital world.
Unsealed Case File. The Stuxnet Virus. 2010. Somewhere in an unknown location, computer hackers and engineers get together to perfect the most effective cyber weapon yet known to man.
The Stuxnet virus was a virus that appeared in 2010. It infected millions of users worldwide. Most of the damage done by this virus was done to computers inside the Iranian nuclear research facilities aimed to enrich uranium. And it's believed that years were taken away from the Iranian scientists in regards to their research due to this virus.
The Stuxnet virus showed the world that a virus, a computer code, could turn the machines against the very people who were using the machines. If you think that can't happen to us, you're making a grave mistake.
Every day, the human race gives up a little more humanity for the sake of convenience. Direct deposit for your paychecks. Automated customer service lines. Smartphones that do what a personal assistant used to do. It seems as though people no longer need people at all. Coming up, how will machines ultimately rule mankind? By eventually merging with them.
You look at the stuff they're doing today, and it's like science and science fiction are indistinguishable.
Unsealed. Conspiracy Files. Welcome back to the world of conspiracy. This is Unsealed Conspiracy Files. Since the Industrial Revolution, mankind has invented machines to do nearly anything a man can do. But now, engineers and scientists are taking things a step further. Unsealed Case File. Man-machine hybrids.
Remember the $6 million man? It's not fiction anymore.
Battery-powered exoskeletons become one with the wearer, allowing a human soldier to double or triple his strength and endurance.
Exoskeleton battle gear is a fantastic help to our combat troops. But what happens when you don't need the human being inside the exoskeleton anymore?
If you look at what we're capable of today, it's like science and science fiction are indistinguishable.
And scientists have more fully integrated man-machine crossovers already in place. Eyes, hands, arms, even synthetic human flesh. If a person has it, somewhere an engineer is figuring out how to give it to a robot. Biodesign, a new project at DARPA, is making the impossible possible. It intends to create synthetic organisms that will be programmed to live indefinitely.
Not only have we created a robot, we're giving it the gift of immortality.
If you start to program it to be self-replicating, it goes out, puts another copy of itself together, programs it, sends it off into the universe. That one becomes two, the two becomes four, four becomes eight, so on and so forth. In a very short amount of time, these probes could, in theory, start to take over the world.
Of course, robots only do what they're programmed to do. But what happens when they're programmed to fool us? Unsealed Case File. The Turing Test. 1950. Alan Turing, one of the fathers of modern computing, poses a simple question. Can machines think? The field of artificial intelligence is born.
The Turing Test was created to determine whether or not an artificial intelligence software could act human-like. The test would involve three different subjects: the judge, a computer, and an actual human. The judge would communicate and send messages to the computer via text and messages to the human and receive a response. Based on the response, if the judge couldn't figure out which one was human, it would pass the Turing test.
And computers just keep getting better.
I don't think it's very hard for a machine to actually convince the human that it's human.
Since the advent of social networking, a whole new artificial entity has emerged, the social bot.
There are computer programs and scripts out there that traverse the net and think for themselves, can hack into websites, can actually communicate and send messages with you. If you're on Facebook or some type of social network platform, all of a sudden you get a message from somebody. Sometimes there's not a human on the other end.
How soon before the robots that can fool us become the robots that can rule us? It's more likely than you think.
What might happen if software programmers are able to provide that power, that ability for computer-driven robots to think, to make decisions on their own without input from their human creators?
The rise of thinking, synthetic, immortal organisms could spell the end of the human race. So what happens when the robots rise up and take technology away from mankind?
Everything shuts down. Your cell phone doesn't work. Your GPS doesn't work. Your car doesn't even work because it's computer driven. Nothing in your life that works by computer operates. And that could only be the beginning of the end.
A massive meltdown creates worldwide panic. Satellites go offline. Power grids fail. Water supplies disappear. The Earth goes dark.
Your phone, your computer, your car, they're all part of the Matrix.
The drones that think for themselves, the weapons that basically define their own targets. What happens when they turn on us?
Thankfully, the time when machines take over for mankind still lies in the future. But you'll never believe what they're already doing today. When we return, the mind-blowing truth about robots with a license to kill.
When a machine's given the authority to decide to kill a human, we call that the kill clause.
Unsealed. Conspiracy Files. Welcome back to the world of conspiracy. This is Unsealed. Conspiracy Files. The time to act is now. There are three simple steps you can take to unseal the truth.
Follow on Twitter.
Follow the Unsealed Twitter feed to receive breaking news of the latest conspiracies as they develop.
Tell your story.
What did you see that you shouldn't have?
The government's known about it all along. Why has nobody told us?
Upload stories and pictures to our interactive map.
Join the movement.
Get the Unsealed bracelet and the unique code hidden underneath to access exclusive content. Stop living in the dark.
It is definitely coming this way.
Get involved in the fight to unseal the truth. Now.
Due to the graphic nature of some images, viewer discretion is advised.
Perhaps the most disturbing development in state-of-the-art robotics is also the most deadly. It's known as the Kill Clause. A 2008 report prepared for the U.S. Navy outlines its intention.
Imagine the face of warfare with autonomous robotics, mobile machines that can make decisions, such as fire upon a target without human intervention, can replace the soldier in an increasing range of dangerous missions.
Will these devices actually be able to make kill decisions based on the actions of the human beings they're targeting?
We can't be sure that that's not already happening.
Robots have been designed to think, to feel, to replicate, to fool us, and most dangerously, to kill us. It's not a matter of if the machines will take over, but only when. Unsealed. Conspiracy Files.